Hello, this is Matthew Chan. Thank you for visiting webdominationstrategies.com. In this video, I'm going to discuss the role of email addresses as it pertains to establishing your internet presence. And you're probably thinking to yourself, email address? I mean, this is not what I signed up for. I mean, who cares about an email address? Well, what does this have anything to do with my online reputation? Well, I have to tell you, it does have a small role on it. And the reason why it has a role is because most of us have to share our email addresses, whether it's on our business cards or our websites, or even verbally telling somebody what it is, if you want someone to communicate with you. And your email address, for many people, is your first point of contact. And the email address that you use is sends sort of a subtle message to the people that is viewing it. For example, most people traditionally have used their first initial and last name as part of their email address, which is perfectly fine. It doesn't have a lot of personality, but it's very straightforward. Everyone understands it. Another alternative is, for example, they'll use their full first name, but use their last initial. Like in my case, it would be Matthew C. In the first example, it would be mchan@soandso.com. In the second example, it would be like MatthewC@soandso.com. And those two are fairly, they work. They're not flashy, and it just works. Now, there are other email addresses that are a little bit more colorful. I've seen all kinds of email addresses being used, and they use very colorful names. Like, for example, if you decided that, you were in, in the flashlight business, okay? But if you give your email address as, like, flasher@soandso.com, it might send the wrong message. I mean, you're in the flashlight business, but you're calling yourself Flasher. So, you know, someone may not take that too kindly as part of an email address, and it sends a little message, even though you had the best of intent. You're trying to be cute, but it also sends, you know, a secondary message. Now, I think for the benefit of this video, I think most of us can use a little bit of common sense, not to use anything too provocative as the first part of your email address. Also, another thing that I would avoid is to not use like very complicated numeric strings. Like, for example, you can use like Matt 35241. I mean, which is very, very arbitrary. Now, having said that, some of you already know what my personal email address is, and I probably will change it at some point, but I am sort of guilty of that, mainly because of the legacy thing. But the only saving grace is it is relatively unique, but as a general rule, I would avoid elaborate numbering or alphanumeric patterns for the first part of your email address. Now the second part is probably a little bit more controversial, and it might offend some of you that are listening to this video, and obviously my intent is not to offend, but it's to share a perspective. And there are many free email addresses, email services available today. Among them is Gmail by Google, Yahoo Mail, we've got Microsoft's Hotmail, and of course, the old standby AOL Mail. Now, it's very, very telling to a guy like me when someone gives me an AOL address or a Hotmail address. It basically means that they were around in those days and they needed the free service and they never bothered to change it. And the problem that I see is that it really does date you. And it does paint you as a sort of like old school, if you're, and which is not a good thing if you're actually trying to convey an image that you're current, you're with the times, and so forth. So, without doubt, out of all the email services, as I make this recording in late 2011, by far the preferred choice is Gmail, Google Mail, because Google's dominant. Gmail's considered cool. They're innovative. And now, whether or not that holds 5 years from now, I can't say. But for the here and now, from an image point of view, Gmail is the coolest. Okay, it has the coolest factor and is considered to be reputable. Now, following Gmail, in my opinion, we've got Yahoo Mail. I've never really been crazy about the name Yahoo. You know, I mean, I know it was supposed to be humorous and simple and all that stuff, but, you know, it sounds a little hokey to me. But nevertheless, I have a Yahoo email address, which I use as a secondary address. And so in terms of coolness and being up to date and so forth, I rank Yahoo email addresses as being second. Now, the third and fourth positions are very, very close between the two among the popular email services, which is Hotmail and AOL. I gotta tell you, I've never liked Hotmail as part of my email address. There's just something about it. It just sounded cheesy to me. Maybe it's just my sensibilities, but I've never liked it. Yes, I have a Hotmail address mainly so I can access some of the more Microsoft exclusive services. They mandate that you have a Microsoft email address, and I use that for those special cases. But other than that, it never gets publicized. And of course, last but not least is AOL. And I have tried to gently over the years tell my friends that they should probably get rid of the AOL address. It just does not paint them well as for people who are wanting to be known as cutting edge, modern, and so forth. An AOL address basically spells old timer, out of date, out of touch. So if you got an AOL address, yes, I know you've had it for a long while, but if you're trying to spruce up your internet reputation as being modern, I would ditch it. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video and my take on email addresses as it pertains to your internet presence. And I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.